As Pi Kappa Phi launched into its third quarter century, the fraternity sought to grow its membership. Soon after celebrating its 50th anniversary in 1954, Pi Kappa Phi planted the flag at new institutions around the country by welcoming Beta Kappa at Georgia State, Beta Lambda Chapter at Tampa, Beta Mu at McNeese State, Beta Nu at Houston, and Beta Xi at Central Michigan. Brothers across the country continued to contribute in politics, athletics, and the business world. In 1954, Pi Kappa Phi alumnus Malcolm Johnson's Pulitzer Prize-winning expose on organized crime in New York City was made into a feature film called On the Waterfront, starring Marlon Brando. In 1959, Pi Kappa Phi's magazine, The Star and Lamp, marked 50 years of publication. First published in 1909 as the Pi Kappa Phi Fraternity Journal, Pi Kappa Phi's magazine has welcomed new chapters, honored alumni contributions, and shared news with brothers around the world. Later in 1959, the fraternity sought new leadership as Pi Kappa Phi struggled to recruit new members and engage alumni. National historian Louis Packy Gervais sought out Xi alumnus Durwood W. Owen, then a local businessman in Virginia, to ask if he would be interested in serving the fraternity as executive director. Durwood interviewed with the National Council at Supreme Chapter in Louisville, and on March 16, 1959, he accepted the job and agreed to come to Sumter, South Carolina, and serve as executive director for only 2 years. Durwood's wife, Connie, later said it was the longest 2 years she had ever experienced, as Durwood would go on to serve the fraternity until 1994. One of Durwood's first assignments as executive director was to oversee the first Pi Kappa College during the summer of 1959. 102 brothers from across the country gathered at Burt Ginn Wilderness Camp in South Carolina to attend one of the fraternity world's first leadership conferences. Pi Kappa College proved to be an empowering experience, as the inaugural session yielded a future national president and a Mr. Pi Kappa Phi. Of course, many other fraternity leaders would attend Pi Kappa College in the coming years. As the civil rights movement gained momentum and acceptance, one of the fraternity's most well-respected leaders also sought to bring equality to Pi Kappa Phi. From 1964 to 1966, National President Mel Metcalf, Alpha Gamma, Oklahoma, traveled to every chapter in the country to speak with members about changing the fraternity's membership requirements to include men of character, regardless of race or creed. Metcalf's personal efforts helped welcome progress as brothers at the 1966 Supreme Chapter in Miami, Florida, amended Supreme Law to make Pi Kappa Phi a more inclusive fraternity. Without Metcalf's choice to lead and willingness to open up a dialogue with brothers, the decision to welcome brothers of all backgrounds would have been a much more difficult process. Under Metcalf's leadership, the National Council also created the fraternity's most distinguished award. In 1965, Omicron alumnus Leo Poe was honored as the first Mr. Pi Kappa Phi. In addition to serving as a past local volunteer and as a past National Council member, he was also recognized for his generosity. Since his initiation, Poe had financed the initiation fees of more than 70 brothers, allowing them to join the fraternity and pay off their debts gradually. As the fraternity continued to grow, leadership sought a more permanent headquarters. In June of 1965, the national headquarters was moved to 1924 Vail Avenue in Charlotte, North Carolina. This would be the first home office in Charlotte and the first office owned by the fraternity. 1 year later in 1966, Pi Kappa Phi Properties made its first acquisition with the purchase of a chapter house in Memphis for the Gamma Delta chapter. The fraternity's properties arm has continued to aid chapters with loans, leases, and assistance in finding competitive housing. As the turbulence of the 1960s swirled around college campuses, higher education professionals and students alike debated the significance of fraternities. With counterculture movements gaining popularity, fraternity growth and even relevance would take a hit. After struggling desperately for a number of lean years, Pi Kappa Phi was able to right the ship and find success during chaotic times. In fact, from 1959 to 1969, Pi Kappa Phi grew the average chapter size from 19 to 39 men. Much of this success was credited to the efforts of Durwood Owen and Assistant Executive Director Ted Scharfenstein, who made recruitment, education, and expansion a priority of the fraternity in the 1960s. As the 1970s began, Pi Kappa Phi suffered the loss of the final loyal Nu Phi member. On January 31, 1972, Dr. A. Pelsner Wagoner passed to the chapter eternal at the age of 85. Founder Wagoner was Chancellor Professor Emeritus of the College of William and Mary, former National President of Pi Kappa Phi, and the founder of Xi Chapter at Roanoke College. Later that same year, the fraternity welcomed one of its most famous members to the Brotherhood, Randy Owen, lead singer of the Grammy Award-winning country band Alabama, was initiated as a founding father of the Delta Epsilon chapter at Jacksonville State. Earlier in 1971, U.S. Senator Gaylord Nelson, a Democrat from Wisconsin and founder of Earth Day, was initiated into the Gamma Nu chapter at LaGrange University. The fraternity also welcomed its 100th chartered chapter in April of 1972, as the Delta Delta chapter was chartered at Truman State in Missouri. With its membership now bolstered with more than 30,000 brothers across the country, Pi Kappa Phi would soon set its sights on creating even more opportunities for members to connect with fellow brothers and to better the world around them.